Welcome. Once again, welcome to my channel. Now I'm going to talk about the totally new topic. This is actually the topic of CNS, Central Nervous System, and this is your neurophysiology. Now I'm starting the pain physiology, or physiology of pain. Okay, so physiology of pain. Now, so first of all, what is pain? Okay, so what is pain? Pain, definition of pain. So for definition of pain, here you can see, this is pain. This is nothing but a unpleasant sensation. Okay, you can see the definition here. Yes, pain is defined as an unpleasant sensory pain is defined as unpleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with actual or potential tissue damage or described in terms of such damage. Okay, this is actually given by your International Association for the Study of Pain, IASP. So that's this is the little bit fact based. This is definition of pain. Okay, so now let's talk about the proper understanding of pain, proper conceptual things related with pain physiology. Okay, so look here. So first, for your pain sensation, okay, so let's imagine this is your skin. Okay, this is your skin. I'm drawing a schematic representation. This is your skin. Okay, and for pain sensation, some receptors are present. Okay, some receptors which are a response, which are a response in your pain sensation. Okay, so some receptors are present on your skin. Okay, this is the receptors. So the receptors which sensed the pain, the receptors, they are called your nociceptors. Okay, nociceptors. What is nociceptors? So nociceptors is your pain sensing receptors. Okay, pain sensing receptors, this is called your nociceptor. Now what is actually nociceptor? What is nociceptor? Okay, so nociceptor is nothing but, I already told, this is a piece of skin. Okay, so what is nociceptor? Nociceptor is nothing but the free nerve ending. Okay, you can see here one neuron. Okay, this is one neuron, this is one neuron. Okay, or this is some bundles of neurons. Okay, so various neurons are there. So this is called your nerve. Okay, so bundles of neuron is called nerve in peripheral nervous system, and bundles of neuron in central nervous system is called tract. Okay, so the bundles of neurons and their free nerve endings, you can see here the free nerve endings. This one, this is free nerve endings. What is the meaning of free nerve endings? Here no myelin. Okay, this same, similarly, there is also no myelin. This is, there is also no myelin. That's why they are called your free nerve ending. Okay, so this nerve is ending point is here and here also. This is your free nerve ending. This free nerve ending is actually is your nociceptor. Okay, so it is written in Guyton that some ion channels are present in your free nerve endings. Okay, some ion channels are present at the level of, some ion channels are present at the level of free nerve ending, at the level of free nerve ending. Okay, so these ion channels are actually your nociceptors. These ion channels are actually your nociceptors. These ion channels are actually your nociceptors. These ion channels are acts like nociceptors. Okay. So one thing, these ion channels, they are actually the TRP group of ion channels. These are actually TRP group of ion channels. What is TRP group of ion channels? TRP group of ion channels, that means, what is the full form of TRP? This is your transient receptor, transient receptor potential, transient receptor potential channel. Okay, so this is your TRP, transient receptor potential channel. Okay, so now you can see here I'm drawing two nerve ending. One is this and another one is this. Why I am drawing two nerve ending? Because the pain, this is actually carried by two types of nerve fibers. The pain carrying nerve fibers are mainly two types. Okay, so one is your A delta type, okay, and another one is your C type. Okay, but now what is A delta type and what is C type? What is the meaning of A delta and what is the meaning of C of nerve fibers? Okay, so this is actually the based on your Erlanger-Gasser classification. Okay, this is actually based on your Erlanger and Gasser classification. Okay, so based on Erlanger-Gasser classification, the nerve fibers are how many types? Can you tell me? The nerve fibers are A, B, C. Okay, three types. Okay, based on the Erlanger-Gasser classification, the nerve fibers are three types. Okay, so now what is the basis of this Erlanger-Gasser classification? I will just give you a quick recap or the basis, the fundamentals of Erlanger-Gasser classification. Okay, because this is a totally separate topic of neurophysiology. From above to below, from A to C, your myelination decreased. Okay, from above to below, A to C, your myelination decreased. Okay, A types of nerve fiber, further it is classified into A alpha, A beta, A gamma and A delta. Okay, A alpha, beta, gamma and delta. Okay, from above to below, where it is, shit, yes, from above to below myelination decreased. Okay, from above to below your myelination decreased. So A alpha is highly myelinated. Myelination is very high in A alpha. Okay, and C fiber, C is no myelination. There is non-myelinated. Okay, so there is no myelination in C fiber. A fiber highly myelinated, B relatively less myelinated with respect to A, and C fiber no myelination. Okay, so these all are A alpha, A beta, A gamma, A delta. Similarly, they are also myelination is also less in delta with respect to these three. Okay, so myelination is reduced from above to below. This is the basis of your Erlanger-Gasser classification of nerve fibers. Okay, now I already told you the pain carrying fibers are two types. This is one is your A delta fiber and another one is your C fiber. Okay, so already you can see here that A delta fiber, it is myelinated. Okay, but C fiber is totally non-myelinated. Now here you can see one thing. So you can see here now A delta myelinated, okay, and C non-myelinated. Okay, based on this fiber which is carrying the pain, the pain is also two type. Okay, so one is your fast pain, one is your fast pain, another one is your slow pain. Okay, what is fast pain, what is slow pain? Now I am going to discuss about this. First, once again talk about the stimulus for pain. Okay, the stimulus for pain generation, okay, or pain producing stimulus. So pain producing stimulus are sensed by which receptors? This is your nociceptors. Okay, this is your nociceptors. This is your nociceptors. Okay, so nociceptor is your pain sensing receptors which sense the pain. This is your nociceptors. Okay, now the stimulus which can produce pain, it may be which and which type can you tell me the stimulus? Either it may be your mechanical or maybe your thermal stimulus or maybe your chemical stimulus. Okay, so mechanical stimuli, thermal stimuli or chemical stimuli, okay, they can produce pain. Okay, so stimulus, mechanical, thermal and chemical, they can produce pain. Okay, so these three kinds of stimulus, they are producing pain via activating your nociceptors. Okay, via activating your nociceptors. Three kinds of stimulus activates your nociceptor, and nociceptor is sense the pain sensation. Okay, so this is the receptor for pain receptor, R for receptor. Okay, so nociceptor is activated by various kinds of stimuli, more than one kinds of stimuli. It activates your nociceptor. That's why the nociceptor is also called your polymodal type of receptor. Okay, so nociceptor is stimulated by more than one stimuli. Okay, so nociceptor stimulated by more than one stimuli. What I am writing here, the nociceptor, it is stimulated by more than one stimuli, and that's why your nociceptor is called polymodal or multimodal type of receptor. So what is a polymodal receptor or multimodal receptor? If one receptor is stimulated by various kind of stimuli, like your mechanical stimuli, your thermal stimuli, your chemical stimuli. More than one stimulus activates your nociceptor. Okay, more than one stimulus activates your nociceptor. That's why your nociceptor is called polymodal receptors or multimodal receptors. Okay, for example, can you tell me your photoreceptors, okay, they are present where? They are present in your rod and cone cells. Okay, they are present in your retina of eyeball. Okay, the photoreceptor, for example, just I am explaining these things, it is only stimulated by light. Okay, only stimulated by light. Okay, not other kind of stimulus, not a temperature, not the acid sensation, or not by your sound, etc., etc. So your photoreceptors are only activated by light and cause your, which is the basis of your vision. Okay, so is this photoreceptors are multimodal? They are multimodal or not? No, because they are only stimulated by light stimuli. Only light stimuli can stimulate your photoreceptors, not other stimuli. Okay, so they are not multimodal or polymodal. Okay, but in case of your nociceptor, or this is, it can stimulate it by mechanical stimuli, thermal stimuli, chemical stimuli, all can stimulate. These three kinds of stimuli, more than one stimuli can stimulate your nociceptor. That's why this is called your polymodal or multimodal receptors. All right, now once again I am marking here. Now come to this topic once again, fast pain and slow pain. Okay, so here I already told you mechanical stimuli, thermal stimuli and chemical stimuli. Now I am going to talk about these things. Your pain is two types, fast and slow. Okay, now this fast pain, under this fast pain, which and which stimuli can produce fast pain? Can you tell me? The mechanical stimulus and the thermal stimulus can produce fast pain. Okay, so already you saw that you can see here that mechanical, thermal and chemical, three kinds of stimulus can produce pain. Okay, by activating the nociceptors. But your fast pain is only produced by two kinds of stimulus, either your mechanical stimulus and thermal stimulus. Okay, thermal stimulus is further two types, hot sensation and cold sensation. Okay, and slow pain is produced by mechanical stimulus, okay, thermal stimulus and also chemical stimulus. Okay, so you can see mechanical stimuli, thermal stimuli and chemical stimuli, three kinds of stimuli can produce your slow type of pain. Okay, so that's about the pain producing stimuli. Now this one detail which I want to add here, this is your about chemical stimuli. So the pain which is produced by your chemical stimulus is called your chemical pain. Okay, so chemical pain, this is also called your burning type of pain. So burning type of pain or chemical pain, they are under slow pain category. They are under slow pain or second pain. So now what is the fast pain and what is the slow pain? So let's discuss about the fast pain and slow pain, and then I will talk about the nociceptors detail, little bit detail. Okay, so what is first pain? So I already told that the first pain is carried by your A delta nerve fiber, and slow pain is carried by your C nerve fiber. Okay, so from receptor to your central nervous system. Okay, this is your afferent nerve fiber. Afferent nerve fiber carrying the, here somewhere is receptor, afferent nerve fiber carrying the pain sensation from receptor to central nervous system. Okay, now these afferent nerve fibers are two types in case of pain, A delta and C. A delta carry first type of pain and C fiber carry slow type of pain. Can you tell me why? Because I already told you that based on Erlanger-Gasser classification, A delta, this is myelinated, and C fiber is non-myelinated. So where the myelin is present, if myelin is present, the nerve action potential conduction is faster. So action potential conduction is faster because of due to saltatory conduction. You can see here, this is the myelination of nerve fibers. Okay, here this is the myelinated nerve fibers. Okay, and there is node of Ranvier where the myelination is absent. Where it is, the node of Ranvier is here. You can see the node of Ranvier. This is node of Ranvier. This is node of Ranvier. node of Ranvier. Okay, their myelination is absent, and your action potential is conducted from one node to another node due to presence of myelin. So this is the fastest type of nerve action potential conduction or nerve stimuli conduction. Okay, so myelin is present here in case of A delta fiber, that's why it can carry the pain sensation very fast. Okay, so that's why the first type of pain sensation is carried by your A delta fiber, or the A delta fiber carrying the pain sensation which is faster. But C fiber, there is no myelination. Okay, so there is no myelination, that's why the nerve action potential which is carried through the C fiber is diffuse type. Okay, and this is not specific, so that's why, and also this is slow. Okay, that's why this is also called your slow pain. Now let's talk about the detail about first pain and slow pain. Okay, so first pain and slow pain. First pain and slow pain. So first pain, this is also called your sharp pain. First pain is also called your sharp pain, also called your pricking type pain. Okay, so which is also called your stabbing pain. This is stabbing pain, also called epicritic pain, also called good pain. Why this? Because this is physiologically protective phenomenon, physiologically प्रोटेक्टिव फेनोमेनन, फिजियोलॉजिकली प्रोटेक्टिव फेनोमेनन, दैट्स वाई योर फास्ट पेन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड गुड पेन. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द वेरियस नेम्स ऑफ फास्ट पेन. फास्ट पेन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड शार्प पेन, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड प्रिकिंग टाइप ऑफ पेन, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड स्टैबिंग पेन, एपिक्रेटिक पेन, गुड पेन. ओके, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द वेरियस नेम सिनोनिम्स. ओके, बस और कुछ नहीं, भगवान श्री कृष्ण का सतनाम. नाउ द स्लो पेन, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड योर स्लो पेन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डाल पेन, डाल पेन, डिफ्यूज पेन. ओके, एचिंग, ए सी एच आई एन जी, एचिंग टाइप ऑफ पेन, एकिंग टाइप ऑफ पेन, एकिंग टाइप ऑफ पेन. ओके, नाउ थ्रोम्बिंग पेन. सो कोई काम की बात नहीं, फालतू का चीज़ है. ओके, एंड ऑल्सो वन थिंग इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इज बर्निंग टाइप ऑफ पेन, बर्न, बर्निंग टाइप ऑफ पेन. ओके, सो दिस इज लिटिल बिट इम्पॉर्टेंट, बर्निंग टाइप ऑफ पेन इज अंडर स्लो पेन, दिस इज क्वेश्चन मार्क. ओके, सो बर्निंग टाइप ऑफ पेन इज स्लो पेन. ओके, सो नाउ दिस ऑल आर सिनोनिम्स ऑफ फास्ट पेन एंड स्लो पेन. नाउ वी कैन सी हियर, स्लो पेन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड योर बैड पेन, बैड पेन. ओके, सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट द नेमिंग ऑफ फास्ट पेन, स्लो पेन. नाउ कम टू द रियल कॉन्सेप्चुअल एरिया. लेट्स इमेजिन, हियर आई एम ड्रॉइंग योर लोअर लिम्ब एंड ओके, सो दिस इज ए हैमर ऑब्वियसली, रबर पैड. ओके, नाउ दिस हैमर इज स्ट्राइकिंग ऑन योर नी. ओके, दिस हैमर इज स्ट्राइकिंग ऑन योर नी एंड सडनली व्हाट हैपेंस, योर द पोजिशन ऑफ योर लेग इज टुवर्ड्स दिस और कॉजिंग द फ्लेक्शन, फ्लेक्शन ऑफ योर लेग. ओके, सो एट द मोमेंट जस्ट इमेजिन when the hammer is striking on the knee with a great potential, okay, with a high potential, the hammer is striking on your knee. Okay, at that moment just when the hammer is striking on your knee, okay, just at that moment what happens, you can feel a highly intense pain, highly intense pain. Okay, you can feel a highly intense pain but for very short duration or low duration, short duration or low time duration. Okay, you can feel a high intense pain for less time, low duration. Okay, just at the moment, just concentrate at this point. Once again I am telling, just at the moment when this hammer is striking on your knee, you can feel a high intensity of pain, highly intense mechanical pain. Okay, this is produced by mechanical, this is produced mechanically, high intense mechanical pain for low duration or short duration, very short, SHRT, very short duration. Okay, This pain is called your first. This is your first pain. Okay, but after sometimes, you can feel also the sensation of pain after this hammer is now removed. No hammer now, there is ओके यू ऑलरेडी स्ट्राइक्ड यू द हैमर इज ऑलरेडी स्ट्राइक्ड ऑन योर नी एंड रिमूव्ड ओके आफ्टर समटाइम्स यू कैन फील लिटिल बिट पेन अराउंड योर नी बट यू कैन नॉट लोकेट द एरिया properly from where the pain is coming you cannot locate the area properly from where the pain is coming okay so this kind of pain is your slow pain or dull pain or diffuse pain okay this is one example and from this example one point which can I add here this your the flexor withdrawal reflex flexor withdrawal reflex is due to which kind of pain can you tell me the flexor withdrawal reflex or flexor withdrawal response is due to first pain because suddenly when the hammer is striked on your hammer is striking on your knee you remove your leg okay this is due to your first pain And after this pain, first pain, you removed your hammer, okay, but already you striked by a hammer and then you can feel little bit pain surrounding your knee. This is your slow kind of pain. Now, one example which I want to add here, first note this, this may be a question, okay. Flexor withdrawal response is due to, or flexor withdrawal reflex is due to your first pain, okay. So one thing, we all are in our college in hematology lab. One thing we done that finger pricking. Okay, finger pricking. Yes. So this finger pricking, this is a pricking kind of pain. It can produce a pricking kind of pain. You can locate the area from where the pain sensation is coming properly. Okay, you can locate from where the pain sensation is coming properly. Okay, you can locate the area properly. This type of pain is carried by your A delta fiber. Okay, and this is also a first pain. But let's imagine your abdominal cramp. Okay, but abdominal pain. Or angina pectoris or chest pain okay angina you cannot locate from where your chest or abdomen from where your chest or abdomen the pain is coming you cannot locate properly from where the sensation of pain of your chest or abdomen is coming okay this is not a specific point pain sensation This is a diffuse type of pain sensation, which is carried by C fibers, or this is slow kind of pain, and this is fast kind of pain. Okay, so now let's add more detail on the difference between fast pain, slow pain, or A fiber or C fiber. So, first, I am going to draw the pathway. So your pain carrying pathway is pain is carried by your lateral spinothalamic tract okay so I'm drawing your cut section of spinal cord okay so you can see this is the gray matter so this is the dorsal horn this one this is also dorsal aspect this is dorsal aspect and this is your anterior ventral aspect this is the ventral horn this is also ventral horn lateral horn may not be present okay now the lateral spinothalamic tract okay so first the here is your receptor and from the receptor fibers are coming okay and this is your what this is the cell body. Now receptors are receptors carrying quick pain fibers, either it is A delta or C, come into the spinal cord and enters through the dorsal horn of the spinal cord, and then here it synapses with, so this is your first order neuron, okay, and then here it synapses with the second order neuron. This is your second order neuron. Let's imagine this is the midline of your body. Second order neuron crossing contralaterally. This is second order neuron crossing contralaterally to the opposite side of the body, okay, and then ascends upward through lateral column of spinal cord. I think you know the arrangement of spinal cord, that this is your dorsal column, fibers passing through this. This is anterior column and their lateral column, dorsal, anterior, lateral column, okay, and these fibers are originating from spinal cord and ending at thalamus. That's why they are called spinothalamic tract, okay. So now I'm drawing, okay, this is your cerebral cortex, sensory cortex, broadband area 3, 1, 2, okay, and this is your sensory cortex, okay, now, and this is your thalamus, okay, so this is thalamus, the relay center of all sensory information. And now this is your spinal cord, okay, this is your central canal of spinal cord. I'm dotted the gray matter. Now you can see the receptor, from receptor your dorsal the afferent fibers are coming, either it is A delta or C, both pathway are same, and enters through the dorsal horn of spinal cord, okay, they are ending, if it is A delta fiber, it ends at dorsal horn of spinal cord level, either at layer 1 or layer 5, but if it is C fiber, it ends at layer 2 or layer 3 of dorsal horn, okay. This is also called the substantia gelatinosa of Rolando, substantia gelatinosa. So C fibers ends at here, A fibers end here. I will show you the diagram for this, okay. So now this is your first order neuron, and second order neuron originates inside the spinal cord. It cross contralaterally, this is your midline of body, crossing contralaterally anterior to the central canal, okay, and then it moves upward, okay, it moves upward and relay at thalamus. This is your second order neuron. This is also A delta or C, does not matter, okay. So there is one synapse within your spinal cord, one synapse, okay. So first from receptor, your A delta C fiber, afferent fiber, enters through the dorsal horn of spinal cord, and here is your dorsal root ganglion, DRG, dorsal root ganglion, the collection of cell bodies of afferent neurons. And then the second order neuron originates within spinal cord, okay, and second order neuron cross the spinal cord contralaterally and then ascends upward through the lateral column of spinal cord. This is the lateral column, this portion lateral, this portion also lateral, and then relay at thalamus level, okay. And from thalamus your third order neuron is originates and goes into central cerebral cortex, okay, sensory cortex 3-1. This is your third order neuron. So this is actually the pathway of pain, okay. So, or this is actually the, this is much, actually the C fibers are not following this pathway. So this is actually the pathway of spinothalamic tract pathway, lateral spinothalamic tract pathway. They are originating from spinal cord. These fibers, the nerve fibers, are originating from your spinal cord and goes or ending or goes where? The thalamus, and ending at thalamus. That's why they are called spinothalamic tract. And then after thalamus, third order neuron originates and reach up to central cortex or cerebral cortex, which is your main destination or ultimate destination, okay. So this is your the pathway of spinothalamic tract. Now I think you can understand this, okay. Now there is little bit difference, okay, in fibers, which C fibers which carrying the slow type of pain, they are not like this, okay. Actually they are not reaching up to the thalamus, okay. So I will tell you these things. Now here you can see the I am drawing parallelly the A fiber, A delta, okay, A delta fiber. This is spinothalamic tract, lateral spinothalamic tract, okay. This is A delta fiber ascending. This is second order. I am drawing from the second order. Due to lack of space, I am drawing from this second order neuron. And this second order neuron reach where? Into thalamus. Into thalamus. Okay. And then from thalamus to where? The cerebral cortex. Cortex 312 broadband area. And from thalamus the third order neuron is arising and reaching where? The cerebral cortex. Now similarly, parallelly, I am also drawing the C fibers, second order C fiber, which is originating from spinal cord and reaching thalamus or relaying at thalamus. And then third order neurons are not originating in this case, okay. Actually the C fibers, majority of C fibers are terminating at thalamus. And what happens now, the C fibers during the course towards thalamus, they are giving various collaterals to where? The periventricular area of hypothalamus, okay. So the C fiber is giving collateral to hypothalamus. Which region of hypothalamus? periventricular areas of hypothalamus. And the C fiber also giving collateral to periaqueductal gray. I will show you what is periaqueductal gray. First complete the note. And also collateral to your reticular formation. Okay, so C fibers, this is also the component of lateral spinothalamic tract, and C fibers carrying the slow kind of pin. Okay, it ascends towards thalamus from spinal cord, the second order fibers. During its journey, C fibers gives collateral to periventricular area of hypothalamus, periaqueductal gray, and reticular formation, also called reticular activating system, RAS, reticular activating system. Okay, so very few numbers of C fibers are reaching to thalamus, and they are terminating at the thalamus level. Okay, but the A delta fiber is not terminating at thalamus level. A delta fiber actually reaching one nucleus of thalamus. This is called ventero postero medial nucleus, mainly ventero postero lateral. Okay, so A delta fibers are reaching at ventero postero lateral nucleus of thalamus, and then from thalamus the third order neuron originates, and ultimate they reach up to cerebral cortex. Okay, so this is this is the major difference between the course of A delta and C fibers. Okay, now come here, what is your periaqueductal gray? So this is the cross section of your midbrain. It does not matter it is at superior colliculus level or inferior colliculus level, and you can see the aqueduct of sylvius. Okay, through which your CSF is flowing. Okay, CSF is maintaining its continuity throughout the ventricle. This is flowing through the aqueduct of sylvius of midbrain, and your gray matter surrounding this aqueduct of sylvius region, okay, towards the periphery of aqueduct of sylvius, is called your periaqueductal gray. Okay, periaqueductal gray. Okay, the gray matter present towards the periphery of aqueduct of sylvius, it is called your periaqueductal gray at midbrain level. And what is about reticular formation? I'll tell you each and every detail now. So now you can see, I'll tell you each and every detail about these three, don't worry, and their importance. Okay, pain physiology is not so easy topic. Okay, so you can see your, I already told you, the A delta fiber is reaching where? The A delta fiber is reaching up to thalamus, VPL nucleus, VPM, ventropostolateral, ventropostomedial nucleus of thalamus. Now the location, the specific, actually the from which location your pain is coming, the localization of pain sensation is due to your ventropostero-lateral nucleus of thalamus. Okay, so I am adding one liner here that the localization of pain sensation, the localization of pain is due to ventropostero-lateral nucleus. Okay, then ventropostero-medial nucleus of thalamus. Okay, and not by the cerebral cortex. So cerebral cortex is not responsible for localization of pain. Okay, so now you can correlate one thing. A delta fiber is only rich up to ventropostero-lateral nucleus, but very few C fibers are reaching at ventropostero-lateral nucleus of thalamus. Okay, actually C fibers are reaching into non-specific nucleus of thalamus. They are diffuse type. Actually, they are you cannot say properly that C fibers are reaching into VPL or VPM nucleus. They are reaching up to thalamus, very few in numbers, but and also in non-specific nucleus. Okay, so that's why pain carrying through the C fiber is not localized. Okay, is not localized. Oh, why? Because the very few or no fibers are reaching up to the ventropostero-lateral nucleus of thalamus. Very few or no fibers of C are reaching here. That's why the pain carrying through the C fiber is not localized. You cannot locate properly. Okay, finger pricking pain, you can locate it properly from where your finger pain is coming. But in case of abdominal cramp or in case of angina, you cannot locate properly from where the pain sensation is coming. Okay, so now this is one point. And now the what is the role of cerebral cortex in pain sensation? Can you tell me what is the role of cerebral cortex in pain sensation? So actually the cerebral cortex is it is actually the sensed the type or it can determine the type of pain. Is it is a mechanical type of pain, or it is a burning sensation, or chemical type of pain, or it is the quality of pain. Quality of pain, it is judged. Quality of pain is judged by your cerebral cortex. The quality of pain is judged by your cerebral cortex, and your cerebral cortex is not responsible for localization of pain. So the localization of pain is due to VPL of thalamus. Okay, so I'll continue the same thing in my next session, part 2 video. So pain, it is most important. I think the pain physiology is most important and not so easy. It is also most complicated thing. Actually CNS is not so easy. So